We all want faster internet. I believe that is why you are watching this video. But how can you make your connection faster? The truth is, you don't have a lot of possibilities to make one single line faster. But you can add a second, third, or fourth connection to your home and aggregate them. Multipath TCP, or short MPTCP, is one possibility which I will show you today. I will run this in a test lab which I have built on my Proxmox server. Stay tuned. Just a quick reminder, if you want to skip parts of the video, please use the chapter markers here on the timeline and in the description of the video. Whenever I talk about other videos, then you will see that little info icon up here, and that will link you directly to that video. Thanks, guys. I've made a couple of videos in the past on how to bond multiple internet connections together by using OpenVPN tab devices and Linux bonding. MPTCP is a much easier way to do this. It's also more reliable, much easier to implement, and of course, it's free. Here's how it works. The idea behind all this is called inverse multiplexing. Don't worry, I didn't know that term until I looked it up on Wikipedia. In a nutshell, breaking a data stream into many streams which go at a lower speed and aggregating them together at the endpoints. So one fast connection on one end, many slow ones in the middle, gluing them back to one fast on the other end. Today, we will focus on that middle part here and the two endpoints. Traditionally, TCP has fundamentally been designed to be a point-to-point connection. It's a so-called stateful protocol. That means that there are a couple of things that make the transmission over TCP reliable, such as ordering of the packets, acknowledging receipt of a packet, etc. But there is one big challenge that comes with it. As it is stateful, an interruption of the connection will cause the socket to break. Unlike UDP, which is more like throwing packets over the fence to your neighbor and not checking if there was someone on the other side to actually catch them, think of TCP like being a slide or conveyor belt where you put packets on. If the slide or the belt goes away, then the connection breaks. You might have experienced that when you are on, let's say, a video phone call over Wi-Fi. If you then move away from your Wi-Fi hotspot, the phone transitions to mobile connection. What happens? The call gets interrupted until the application, so the app that you are using to make the call, reconnects. In other words, the application level needed to provide the failover which the network layer could not provide. Multipath TCP or MPTCP addresses this in the following way. If an app or software in general opens a TCP connection, then the stream will automatically and transparently be broken down into many substreams. That will usually be one stream for every network interface that you have. The server, or generally speaking device on the other end, would accept connections for one single socket over multiple different routes. So you could connect to that web server by using a DSL line and let's say two or three additional 3G, 4G, LTE or 5G or even Starlink connections. If one line goes down, the connection would not break, but rather be dynamically covered by the remaining lines. You could therefore use MPTCP not only for bandwidth aggregation, so increase the throughput of your line, but also to provide better availability of the line, so better uptime of your internet connection, for example. A third possible application, and the gamers will be very happy to hear that, could be latency optimization. So tell the system to always use the line with the best ping time. Cool. Sounds like an awesome concept. How can we use it at home? The good news is that the Linux kernel Multipath TCP project has made readily available releases as well as patches for the Linux kernel available to the public. Actually, this project is around for a solid 10 years now. How can you check if you are maybe already using Multipath TCP? Well, the easiest is probably to just browse to one of these sites here, like am I using mptcp.de, and it will tell you if your connection is multipath or not. At the time of making this video in the year 2021, most Linux distributions do not have multipath enabled in their kernel. But I'm quite sure that if you're watching this in the future, then this will most probably be activated by default. At the moment, however, one could say this is the next big thing. Currently, however, it is work in progress, like we can see here on the Linux MPTCP upstream project. So how can you check if your distro has it enabled, and more importantly, if it is not the case, how can you enable it? On a Linux machine, open a shell and as root, type sysctl-a and grep for MPTCP. This is what you should see. When I did this on my Ubuntu 20 desktop, this is what I saw, and I was hoping for MPTCP to be usable. But it didn't really work with am I using MPTCP.de. The site bluntly told me that I was not using MPTCP to connect to it. So I assumed, as I said in the beginning, that this was work in progress. I'll come to that in a second. On Ubuntu Server 20 and Debian 10, there was nothing, so it was clearly not enabled yet. From what I found in the internet, it seems that it is implemented in Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Haven't tested it though. I might try CentOS. Now, if you want to enable MPTCP on your machine, then there is a hard way to do this, and there is a more easy way to do this. The harder way is to compile a kernel for your machine from source. You would then need to make sure that the right patches are applied, launch make menu config, enable the MPTCP options, wait a couple of hours for the kernel to be compiled, and then deploy it on your machine. I assume that at this point, the majority of you are curious to hear about the easy alternative. But before we take a look at the second option, we will just quickly have a short break to allow YouTube to show some ads. If you see some ads during the next couple of seconds, please lean back and relax, and maybe use the time to quickly click on that like button if you like the episode so far. And maybe subscribe to my channel. I'll be back. Guys, thanks for your patience, and most of all, thanks for supporting this channel. Ads are an important part of what keeps this channel alive. So many, many thanks for your support. Back to our MPTCP kernel installation. The Multipath TCP project site provides steps on how to install a working kernel as a Debian package. But the most recent kernel version which they provide is 4.9. But I wanted a more recent kernel version. Here's what I did. I already knew that there is a great project using MPTCP made by French software developer Yannick Chabanois, known as Icarus or by its anagram ysurac. His project is called OpenMPTCPRouter. The way his solution works from an architectural point of view is quite similar to the OpenVPN bonding solution which I proposed on this channel in September 2020. That means he's also using a virtual server or VPS in the internet, which aggregates the connections. So I had a look at his installation script for the VPS, and I found that he has created a Debian package to install an MPTCP-enabled kernel on the VPS. Just a quick note here. We will have a look at OpenMPTCPRouter in the next episode and install it in a virtual test lab on my Proxmox environment. So here is a good reason to subscribe to the channel and click that reminder or bell icon so that you get notified when the episode comes out. Back to Yannick's script. The lines in the script which constitute the link to his Debian package are here. So basically what I did, I copied those lines into a new script and downloaded the Debian package from his site and installed it. I'm providing a script that automates this on my GitHub repository. Link in the description. Check the description of this video for the commands to use. After the installation, I have an additional option in group to boot from. I just adapted the group boot menu to add in a delay at boot time so that I can actually choose to boot that kernel. Again, check the description of the video for the commands to use. Once I had booted with that kernel, I then had an MPTCP enabled. Awesome! Now this is one easy way to get an MPTCP enabled system. Many thanks to Yannick Chabanois, ysurac, for putting this together. The next step before we can actually unleash the power of MPTCP is that we need to tell our system which interfaces to use and which interfaces to route through. The way we do this again is quite similar to what we did in the VPN bonding script. Basically, we add routing tables and rules for each interface, telling Linux to route through a specific gateway for each interface rather than just bluntly using the default gateway for all traffic. Typing this in by hand each time is kind of cumbersome. So luckily, there are two scripts which are provided by the Multipath TCP GitHub repository. Just need to copy them to the right location on your system so that they are called whenever the interfaces go up and down. Don't forget to make them executable with chmod. Here is the output of IP rules and IP routes without the script. And here is the output with the script. Please again, see the details in the description of this video. I have, however, noticed a little particularity in the script, and that is the fact that it either assumes a dynamic IP address, so DHCP, or it assumes that the interface is using PPP, like IP modems do. It does not work for static IP addresses, like I had in my Proxmox test environment in the beginning. I have published a modified version of this script on my GitHub repository and will issue a pull request upstream as soon as I can. The system will now automatically route traffic through the right gateways depending which interface we route through. Let's verify by calling mi using mptcp.de and yes, we are MPTCP enabled. Awesome! Perfect! We are all set for multipath TCP. Just a quick remark on the test environment that I'm using. In the real world, I would need various connections to the internet. Let's say my DSL connection, maybe an additional Starlink and additional 4G connections. But that's quite expensive, given the fact that you can quickly consume multiple gigabytes. So I put the whole thing into a virtual environment on my Proxmox server. Here is the layout. One perimeter router to the real world using OpenWRT in a VM. Three traffic shapers that simulate the internet and where I can adjust the network speed, latency and quality to simulate slow or bad lines running in LXC containers, plus another VM running the MPTCP kernel. With this I can simulate three connections going to a server in the internet, which is in fact mine. Physical local network, if you look at it from the virtual world. Guys, as I said before, next episode we will install OpenMPTCPRouter in this environment, and in the following episode I will show you how to set up this test environment on your own. This will totally unleash the power of my Proxmox installation, so you might want to get a Proxmox ready until then if you want to build it on your own. Please see my Proxmox home lab server video for more details. Cool, now let's do another test and see what MPTCP provides us with. I will add another server here to the game and run a performance test with iperf3 between the client and the server to see what throughput we get. While I do this, I'm also monitoring the traffic on the three traffic shaper machines in order to figure out if we are really using the three connections or not. First, let's do this with a standard kernel, which is not MPTCP enabled. As you can see, only one of the three connections is used. The bandwidth that I get is roughly the bandwidth of one single network line, which are limited on the shaper machines. Now, let's do the same test from the MPTCP enabled machines. I have limited each line to 100 megabits up and down, so we would expect a maximum of 300 megabits over that line. Let's go. And effectively, the aggregated speed is, well, not exactly 3 times the speed, but roughly 2.5 times the speed. Not too bad. The cool thing is that I can bring interfaces down and up while I do this, and it would not break the connection. It adjusts perfectly to the remaining links in a transparent and dynamic way. Just what we want. We get better availability and the highest possible bandwidth at the same time. Beautiful. So if we look at this diagram again, we could in fact establish a simple unencrypted VPN connection from home to the VPS, and if we had an MPTCP capable kernel on both sides, then the connection would automatically handle up and down connections as well as optimize the bandwidth for us. That's exactly what we want. Always on, as fast as possible. But guys, this is exactly what we will do in the next episode with OpenMPTCPRouter. Oh, hang on, before I forget it, why did MPTCP not work on my Ubuntu with the miusingmptcp.de website? Doing further research, it turned out that the upstream version of MPTCP, so the version that you will see in the kernel in the future, is different from this version 0 here. Actually, there are two RFC documents of the Internet Engineering Task Force, the IETF, which describe MPTCP. One is RFC 6824 from the year 2013, and the other one is RFC 8684 as of March 2020. That explains why it didn't work. The versions are just not compatible. Guys, that concludes today's episode. Leave me a comment. A like is very much appreciated. Don't forget to subscribe. Many, many thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye for now.